हेलो एवरीवन, जो भी देख रहा है, वेलकम टू दिस पॉडकास्ट. वी आर कॉलिंग इट अ पॉडकास्ट. वी डोंट नो हाउ इट्स गोइंग टू टर्न आउट. सो दिस इज लाइक एन एक्सटेंशन ऑफ द लाइव दैट आदित्य एंड आई स्टार्टेड, एंड वी हैव एडेड अ वेरी आर्डेंट फैन ऑफ अवर्स हु इज गोइंग टू बी बटिंग इनटू ऑल आवर कन्वर्सेशंस फ्रॉम नाउ ऑन. एंड सो से हाय टू रोहित एज वेल.
हाय गाइस.
So today we are going to talk about a movie that's not talked about that often. It's pretty underrated. It's been under the radar for a long time, and we actually spoke about it in a kind of trial podcast that we had a few days back, and decided that we want to explore it a little more because there's just so much to unpack from it. So that's why we're taking that up as a topic for this podcast. The movie is The Secret Life of Walter Mitty, starring Ben Stiller, directed by Ben Stiller. So,
excuse me, just once, can we acknowledge how great a director also Ben Stiller is?
Yeah.
Because yeah. All I knew him for until today was Night at the Museum.
What is that?
And then suddenly he turns up with this gem.
So, To talk about what the movie really is, I want to take it back to why it means so much to me, why we kind of came down to the decision ki iske baare mein hi baat karna hai. So, I mean, in first or second year of college, I actually discovered this movie and I watched it like two or three times because I couldn't unpack everything in the first go. I watched it once and then I watched a few YouTube videos of it. And I discovered what the movie really wanted to say and where it was really coming from. And I realized that it has a lot of heart and it packages a lot of it into humor, which like a regular movie goer would be able to understand and not get bogged down by a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Behind that humor and behind every joke that Walter is made a butt of, there's a lot that the writing is trying to convey. So, taking from that, I actually wanted more people to see this and take away whatever they would take away from it. And therefore, I organized kind of a movie screening in college where I spoke to the department head for English literature. And I was really enthusiastic about it. Because I was like, yaar, kya gem of a movie hai, aur log ko dekhna chahiye, maja aa
jayega. Basically, Vyas, teacher's pet banne ki koshish kar raha tha. That's the translation of this whole incident.
That's also one thing. Apart from me, there were two people who came to see it, which in retrospect was probably a bad idea to schedule it at 8 a.m. in the morning on a Tuesday. So Rohit was actually one of the guys who joined in later.
About his timing, 8 a.m. and everything, because I have actually given a lot of galis to him. So, why do you keep screen at 8 a.m.? Keep it at 11 a.m.
Exactly. And of a movie that is, and of a movie, okay, so if it's an Avengers type event movie, I can understand 8 o'clock in the morning. Something that needs to be appreciated, you first need to wake up. Like, this is a basic step.
I mean, Ruparel ka red tape jo hai na, it is like ki tumko jo classroom hai, you will get it from 8 to 9:30, उसके बाद अखा दिन नहीं मिलेगा. मैं होने वाला क्या है, 2 to 3 p.m. सफाई शेड्यूल्ड, सो तेरे को नहीं मिलेगा ब्रो, सॉरी. So that happened. I scheduled the screening for the movie. Close to nobody showed up. But what really was unexpected from the whole thing was कि जो दो तीन लोग जो आए थे, at the end of the movie we were really able to have a conversation about it, simply because बड़ा group नहीं था.
Right.
We were able to share what each of us took from it. And coincidentally, most of us were from the psychology background, even I am. So we were able to talk about it from that perspective as well. So, I mean, I guess that's a good segue to talking about the movie because a lot of it is based on a real life disorder called maladaptive daydreaming, where the lead character that we have is suffering from this disorder.
What is the disorder? Actually, what is the disorder?
So, the disorder is basically something where the character, like the person who is having that, is not able to complete daily tasks. They are willfully getting drawn into daydreams where they have created an image of themselves which is usually far from reality. And
but to a destructive degree, matlab, because everybody, even I do this a lot of times, but like they must be doing it to a destructive degree.
Yeah, it is so much that it impairs them from actually carrying out daily tasks. Like even if you are talking to me and if I have maladaptive daydreaming, I might be pretending ki main teri baat sun raha hu. But if you ask me, maine kya bola, I wouldn't be able to say anything because I wasn't really there. I was thinking about something else.
I think Vyas does 90% of the times anyway, which is pretending to listen to me. But I think I also have to give him some shoot on this because I spout a lot of nonsense also. So that's fair, I think.
व्यास बडक लाइव होते कारण मला तो तरी दिसत नाहीये कॅमेराचा काहीतरी गुल झाला
मला पण दिसत नाहीये मला पण दिसत नाही हा दिसला
आला
का था
क्या
तू भडका था क्या इसलिए तूने कॅमेरा ऑफ किया क्या
अरे नहीं मेरे को कॉल आ गया मेरे को कॉल आ
गया मैं चुप बैठता हूं तू बोल तू बोल सॉरी
सर सो हां सो या इट लाइक इंपेयर्स देम कंप्लीटली फ्रॉम डूइंग डेली टास्क एंड apart from that there's also like a subconscious element to it because the reason they are zoning out from reality is because they don't see their realistic self as something they look up to so there are self esteem issues there might be resolved issues from childhood from a psychological perspective though there's a lot of factors there all of which the movie definitely doesn't tackle but so that was one thing that drew me to the movie and it gave that added perspective So when we go through the movie, there are a lot of points throughout the film that really show you what the movie is really talking about. It shows you the heart of the character, where the character has been taken through the film. So I guess there are some of these moments which you guys want to talk about. So you can take over from here and like talk about any of those.
Right. It's more than moments. I mean, it's true, but there's a couple moments that really stand out for through the movie for me. And I just wanted to go into why those moments in particular stand out for me. Mm-hmm. And so I picked a theme for the moments that really stand out for me. And I'm just going to talk about them. So in no particular structure, really. I haven't written I have written something down, but it's very loosely structured. So if you guys feel like chiming in, please feel free. So the first moment that I really feel that sets the tone for me is, I know this is very early on and might be true for most films, but it's the opening montage. Hmm. So the start when he is at the train station and when he moves and then you see lines form into the city and those lines settle into a wave pattern, which becomes the floor for the floor for the life building. And then you see him pass over.
Right.
And the music in that particular moment is, in my mind, I don't know why, there's just some music that you, as you grow up, you tend to associate with certain things. So, for example, that moment, what I tend to associate with that music is hopefulness or like a feeling of really uppityness, you know. So, it's a very good place for us to start with a protagonist who, even though his character is very... he's very lacking in self-esteem, he's very downtrodden. It seems like the tone of the movie is very uppity. So that was a very weird but very interesting juxtaposition for me to start the movie with, especially because through music, it gave it a very different feel. If I would have seen that scene without music, it would have been a very different scene for me. The next part that I really wanted to talk about, and I hope that I had a more organic transition into this, but it was the point where he's in the elevator and I forget the guy, Adam Scott. He starts referring to him as Major Tom.
Yeah, yeah.
Because Major Tom is basically a song about some guy who's out in space. So he's trying to bring that into saying ki tu aise ekdam, you're some far-flung guy who's out in space, which you aren't connected to what is going on here right now. But if you look and his femme fatale in the movie, Cheryl Melhoff or Kirsten Wig. She tells him that it's actually a song about someone who's really brave. And that really shifts his point of view. So this is one more thing that I wanted to bring in, which is that most music that you hear, you don't remember for the lyrics. You hear it for how relevant the lyrics are to your situation.
Right.
So for example, So I've heard Major Tom multiple times before, but I've always heard it as either elevator music or as some other song which some 80s guy sang, and it's just very repetitive and very simplistic. So it never really stuck in my mind as something that I should remember. But when this movie really, what this movie effectively does is it packages that something completely different. It packages that whole music as being very synchronous with achievement, or with him trying to go apart somewhere, you know, him starting his adventure. And that is one music that I think is very, that is one piece of music that is very well used throughout the movie. And I also want to talk about, I think Rohit, this will lead very properly into a segue into your moment, which is, I think the non-use of an object is also the use of it. Now, let me explain that, because especially with music, if you think about it, silence is a very effective tool. Because if you go Ajay Atul on every frame, then you are going to be pumping adrenaline 94 times at your normal capacity. But you will never enjoy the soft Shankar Mahadev and points in the script. You know what I'm saying? You'll never enjoy those points as much as you would if you didn't have. So that's the point. The crescendo must be there. And silence is also a very effective tool. So I want to talk about how silence is a very effective tool in background music, especially towards the end of the movie when he gets near the Buzkashi tribes, and when he's with when he's with Sean finally, and he sees the snow leopard, and there is no music at that point in time.
Right.
Which, if you think about it from a, I'm just thinking about it from a normal, like any other film point of view, which is that that moment is actually a crescendo. So there should be something to tell the audience, at least from the background, ki something is happening. But they've used music so effectively in the rest of the movie that if you, that the absence of it is also felt. That's what really stuck with. Like they've done it so well. So I think that was it. But the thing that I'm talking about is how they've used music very effectively throughout this entire movie. Like, it's a very organic process, the way music fades in and out of it. So I really like that.
So yeah, that is true. Majata, for example, like you gave a pretty nice segue for me to go into my points. So the way they have not used music at Stop all at the last. So that scene itself talks about one major quote in the film, that is, beautiful things don't ask for attention. It's the most beautiful quote that you can have in a film like this. And the film is filled with amazing quotes, obviously. The motto that the magazine has, first of all.
From there
to this point where Sean O'Connell says that beautiful things don't ask for attention. So I have always felt that whenever, like, jo point pe wo snow leopard dikhega, wo point pe there will be a soft piano entering and something like that. Realization music, and then it goes into the cinematic orchestration. But it did not happen, because that was the point. Na, Sean O'Connell wahi bolta hai ki, just I like to be in that moment for some point. So I really feel that I love talking about motifs in general, which are there in films or in general in life. Motif is basically a pattern, okay? And in films, when we use it, it is just a recurring pattern which has some symbolic resemblance. Ani, this whole scene, the whole scene about the snow leopard is basically showing that the whole film was a motif for this. The whole film itself comprises of this scene. Because if you see, in the end also, when Walter asks, what about the negative? What was it that? And Sean O'Connell just says ki it was a ghost cat, Walter Mitty, who's very common. So if you see, he's telling him ki it was a ghost cat. It's not literally a ghost cat, or probably it is. You never know till the point the negative is revealed. But he was actually, it is a ghost cat, Walter Mitty. So this is a very, very much obvious a motive that they have kind of spoon-fed, if you latch on to it. Walter Mitty was a snow leopard all along.
Aray, but if you're saying spoons fed, then you can't say if you latch on to it.
Aray, because it's a very complicated point. That's why. So
I tell you.
अरे थोडं असं म्हणजे एक्सेस पर आशिष फरागो वगैरे असं काहीतरी ते
डिस्पॅरेजिंग फरागो
बट द होल फिल्म जस्ट बेसिकली फोकस्ड ऑन द पॉइंट की वॉल्टर मिट्टी वॉज अ स्नो लेपर्ड ऑल अलॉन्ग अँड वी आर प्रॉबेबली शॉन कॉनेरी वी जस्ट हॅव टू बी इन दॅट मोमेंट ऑफ वॉचिंग द फिल्म दॅट्स इट जस्ट
आय वुड टेक इट वन स्टेप फार्दर आय वुड टेक इट वन स्टेप फार्दर आय वुड से जस्ट डोंट अप्लाय टू द मूवी
Right,
they've,
right.
they've romanticized ordinary life in such a beautiful way, which is that beautiful things don't ask for attention. So if something is beautiful, if your life is ordinary, you don't need to do something extraordinary for it to ask for attention. You will get what you have. You will get what you need.
True.
Beautiful things, zarka tumhi kele tha, you don't need to ask for attention. That's the beauty of it. I really like that quintessence of life.
nice reference. So
I think what Aditya, what you just said, how they've portrayed very very ordinary things about life, that really pours over into the kind of dialogues that they've written, especially the ones that happen with Cheryl towards the end. I mean, when the both of them are talking, they're both obviously written as characters are not very like outspoken.
Correct.
So there's some awkwardness there. But there's a lot of organic I can't really
dialogue,
put it
yeah,
but the dialogue seems very organic. It's
very real, because if you see the first ever interaction that happens between Walter and Cheryl, it is so embarrassing if you think about it. Matlab wo dreaming karta hai wo wala conversation nahi
hai. He shows but is Rohit one minute. I don't think it is, because see, it's only embarrassing if the person that is at the socially higher stake realizes that it's embarrassing. Cheryl doesn't even clock it, because in her mind she's only talking to her colleague. Imagine if you take a bokeh mode photo of that colleague, then Walter is just a blur in the background, so she doesn't even clock him at that point. So to Walter, he feels like it's so embarrassing, but it's actually not, because she doesn't even notice him.
I'm not talking about that moment. I'm talking about the actual conversation that they have. Walter is sitting outside the life building, and he is watching and she's like, I like the street novels. So this is one thing which is quite obvious in the photo, and they are just talking. That is such an embarrassing conversation, because you want to have so that is the point which I wanted to state by supporting Vyas's argument. He wo itna organic hai, he just want to chime in some person andar jata hai, ghusta hai conversation, and you realize that you are making a fool out of yourself. So this is the brain is like, bye, and goes away.
And in the same vein, what I absolutely love, and it's not necessarily organic, but this is a very well-handled moment, which is the moment when he's teaching her son all the skateboard tricks, and she is barabbar on the phone for all the time. Every time he does a trick, she's on the phone, and then every time he's doing something very random, like just trying to balance himself, again, she looks at him. I'm not saying this is something that happens to everybody, but I'm saying this is something that's so believable, ki kitni easily possible hai secretary hona.
Right.
It is so simple that it is so genius ki someone could latch on to that moment and shoot it actually. Ki this happens.
Exactly.
Barabar.
Correct.
And that is one of my major points that I loved about the film, is Walter consistently has some person as the motive. Like if you see, the first half of the film is basically mereko Cheryl ko impress karne ka, and that's why he imagined that whole sequence at the subway, ki wo kuda aur wo fire in the building, and everything hai na, and
three legged dog which is called back later on.
And it's a different species, so you know it's an imagination.
That's true.
So at the first half of the film, major chunk of the film is basically Cheryl being the motive, ki he is trying to go somewhere, ki wo usko clue deti hai ki Denmark ya fir udhar Jersey mein hoga, then he gets the clue about that ship, and he's just going, and he's talking with Cheryl on the phone as well. But eventually when he watches O'Connell go into that volcano and everything, and he notices that he has lost it, he comes back home, he's talking with his mom, and he realizes that his mom had given him the clue all along, but he was zoning out. So now the mom becomes a part of his motive, and his dad is also so much part of his motive, so subtly. He wore longboard and the diary. Those two are the only things. Even one major point that you have used for Cheryl to be the motive is the song that it is there, Major Tom. She is singing that song in Iceland. Correct. Where he's singing that song.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So that point in the whole movie is the point, the deciding point. Ki, now, should I actually go on the adventure or should I not? Because going to Iceland is not a big deal. Correct. Or going to Denmark is not a big deal. उधर वो गया फिर वो हेलीकॉप्टर में बैठा चलते हेलीकॉप्टर में चढ़ा
में गया दैट इज द मोमेंट ही स्विचेस
या
द मोमेंट वेयर ही स्टॉप्स बीइंग अ पैसिव
इनडायरेक्टली एक्चुअली सपोर्ट्स हिम ही फॉलोस शेरिल आउटसाइड द पब एंड ही गोस
ही डज इट बट शेरिल डज इट फॉर हिम
दैट्स द होल थिंग सम एक्सटर्नल पुश इज देयर for him to actually try to attain some motive that he wanted to, and that is like marvelously done in the whole film.
Yeah,
correct. I agree.
So that is one. Then then there are only two points which I have actually, which are kind of sort of technical from the writing and cinematography point of view, which I love. The first one is how much Walter is close towards the actual reality. मतलब उसका खुद का रियलिटी है एंड एक्चुअल रियलिटी है बराबर सो द फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज लाइक कि टॉड नाम का जो कैरेक्टर है ही ओनली अकर्स एक्चुअली वंस इन द फिल्म फिजिकली
या
एट द वेरी लेटर स्टेज व्हेन ही इज एक्चुअली टॉकिंग विद दैट टॉड फ्रॉम ई हार्मनी इफ यू सी इन द होल फिल्म दिस इज अ वेरी स्मॉल डिटेल बट इट हैज अ ह्यूज इंपैक्ट इफ यू थिंक अबाउट इट टॉड के साथ जो कन्वर्सेशंस होते हैं उनका जो बीच का इंटरवल है इट स्टार्ट्स गोइंग ऑन बिगर एंड बिगर वंस ही स्टार्ट्स गोइंग ऑन एडवेंचर सुरुवातीला इतके वेळा बोलतो तो त्या टॉडशी की तू प्रोफाइल हे कर ते कर आणि असं सगळं आणि रँडमली आइसलैंड मध्ये सायकल चालवतो हा बावळट आणि टॉड कॉल करतो आणि लाइक तू मैं वॉल्केनो के पास जा रहा है मैंने एक शार्क को मारा बाय
आई विल टॉक टू यू लेटर
म्हणजे इट्स लाइक की अरे मी आता ऑफिसला आहे मला आता मीटिंग आहे क्लायंट आहे बाय तसं आहे ते की मी वॉल्केनो कडे मारलं बाय इट्स सो कॅज्युअल आणि त्याच्यानंतर इट्स अ ह्यूज लेंथ ऑफ टाइम आणि तो जेव्हा हिमालयात असतो वेन इज इन हिमालयज अँड रेंजिंग द माउंटन हा वेन इज इन हिमालयज अँड रेंजिंग द माउंटन्स अँड स्टफ तर तेव्हा ही गेट्स अ टॉड ही गेट्स अ कॉल फ्रॉम टॉड ही गेट्स अ टॉड
एक टॉड ड्रॉप करून जाते
बट दॅट इज सो इंटरेस्टिंग ना हिमालयात त्या लोकांना रेंज टॉड हिमालय में उनको रेन जाता है डूड फोन पे
बट दैट इज आई थिंक दैट इज सस्पेंशन ऑफ डिसबिलीफ मतलब थोड़ा यू नीड टू वर्क विद देम अ लिटिल बिट ऑन दैट
ब्रो सेल टावर्स आज तक हर जगह लग गए प्लीज डोंट लिव इन द डार्क एजेस
सो दैट वाज वन थिंग अबाउट रियलिज्म एंड द सेकंड पार्ट इज डिड यू नोटिस द मैट्रिक्स रेफरेंस
द मैट्रिक्स नो
There is a reference about Matrix in the film. बहुत छोटा reference है, and I read it up. Is it actually like that? So when he lands in Iceland, he asks for a car.
So the red,
like red.
Red
is basically the painful truth, and blue is ignorance. Like it is there in Matrix, and he actually chooses a red car.
Red. Yeah. Oh shit.
I was like, ये क्या है मतलब और I actually tried to find about it. Wikipedia का जो article है ना red pill and blue pill का उसमें इसका reference है.
Oh.
And this is mind blowingly amazing क्योंकि ये film पूरा realistic things पे based है कि उसका daydreaming and realism and red pill blue pill directly लाया रे उन लोग ने.
Shit dude.
I know.
Did not pick up on this at all.
I did.
For that one scene.
Now I'm kind of moving away, but are you done with the point, Rohit? Can I move to the next one that I wanted to discuss?
Just ek hai, chota sa hai, tumhi patkan sampo, discuss kare lo bhaiya. One thing is about the cinematography. It is so brilliant. And it has, I really feel it has some reflections of Wes Anderson ka shooting style. Matlab, bahut symmetrical hai, if you look at the film. बहुत छोटे छोटे चंक्स है बट विच आर वेरी मतलब वॉल्टर किधर तो जा रहा है ऐसा दिखाना होगा ना तो दे आर वेरी सिमेट्रिकल इफ यू ऑब्जर्व मतलब ये फिल्म बाद में वापस देखो दिस इज प्रोबेबली ओनली माय पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू दैट माइट बी देयर बट आई लव वेस एंडरसन सो दैट्स व्हाई दैट प्रोबेबली ज्यादा मेरे को दिखाई दिया. सो वेन एवर वॉल्टर इज रनिंग ना द मेन पोस्टर इट सेल्फ सीक्रेट लाइफ ऑफ वॉल्टर मिटिका ही इज रनिंग समवेयर सो ही इज टू सम मोटिव दैट ही वांट्स टू अचीव. पहली बार जब वो भागता है तो देर आर पोस्टर द लाइफ मैगजीन के वो एक ही बेन स्टीलर एज एन एस्ट्रोनॉट बाकी एक भी नहीं. So he's still into that daydreaming ka thoda zone, but now he's much more out of it. Aisa kuch to symbolism ho sakta hai. But they are running the trolley parallel to him. Like he is in the focus or background hil raha hai. Even when the aeroplane takes off, the aeroplane is in the center. Even when he's cycling the cycle and him is in the center and the background is moving. So that's that really seems very much like it wants to say something. It wants to portray something. This is one thing. And the other thing that I... saw was so this is one key. Whenever he's going towards something, we follow him. But on the other hand, when wo longboard dene jata hai Cheryl ke bacche ko, tab wo longboard rakhta hai and he goes out on the footpath and he starts running. The camera is stationary and he's just running away.
Huh.
He's going away from us. Theek hai? Right. And uska follow
that
shot
symbolism is also clear there. Ki it's not actually, we aren't with him anymore. He's moving away from...
Yeah.
And uska jo follow-up shot hai na, that is the most brilliant shot in the film, I think so. Like anytime if you observe a film, whenever a character enters a new area, we are in the car with the character aur uske OS se hum log pura scenery dikhta hai. Barabar?
Right.
Like we are watching the city for the first time with the character. Aisa kuch ho sakta hai wo. But when Walter leaves that longboard and goes away from her and goes away from the camera as well, we are on the outside of the taxi looking at the city going behind and Walter is just sitting aisa head uska khidki
pe. Also very interesting. In that same frame, there's actually the window is very reflective. So while you're also seeing Walter, you're also seeing what he's seeing.
Right.
That's a very subtle cue. It's a very subtle cue, but it's something that you know exactly what he's staring at. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
I
just have a small little thing about this scene since we are talking about the taxi scene. Like from the perspective of the plot that the movie is putting up, it's basically talking about how Walter is trying to be more in the moment and achieve these kind of dreams that he had for himself, which he never achieved in reality, and therefore transition them to his daydreaming and stuff. So from that perspective, even when he's in the taxi, he starts seeing himself as on the show with Colbert, I think. So and in that scene he consciously like tries to stop himself and tap out of that, and that's like a huge shift in anything that we've seen before, because he's always enjoyed those moments where he's been daydreaming. He sees himself as larger than life. That is somewhere where he can actually be all those things that he never achieved in reality. But even though he's doing that again, he wants to tap out of it so he can be where he really is. And that's symbolized very nicely by him stepping out of the cab.
So you're saying that's the start of his recovery process. Psychologically speaking, that might be the beginning of him stepping into the recovery process or rehabilitation. As
he's acknowledging that he needs to do that.
Mm-hmm. That's nice. And so it just gammat madun. Haan, jo taxi wala jo shot hai na, it is a very recurring shot in the shot that we are talking about, the way the Walter is sitting in the taxi. So, that is a very recurring kind of shot in the cinematic history in general. Okay. But I'll just give you one character and two different actors portraying it. Joker, obviously. There is this same shot which is there. Hum log bahar se kisi ko to vehicle ke khidki pe aisa sar rakh ke dekh rahe. Okay. In the movie Joker by Todd Phillips also, in the start, Joaquin Phoenix is just like this, thoda disturbed and everything, which is very
similar. And then in the end, when he's the Joker, he's been taken away in the police car, he's also doing that same thing.
Yeah.
So that is one. And in the Christopher Nolan universe also, we have the same shot, sideways at the window, but apna Heath Ledger wala Joker is bahar. And he's just enjoying that air. So the similar kind of shot can deliver so many meanings if you look into it also.
Correct.
So Aditya, you wanted to say something. कुछ तो तेरा एक तो
I wanted to just yeah no when you were talking about the cinematography I just wanted to talk about also how effectively they've used text in this yeah. I feel because that's a really great मतलब the way they've used text effects mm-hmm. because as he leaves as Walter leaves for his journey of self discovery I want to say the motto of life magazine is actually a very good way to encapsulate his entire journey but when you do that the way they've shown it in the movie is very different from every other movie which is why it catches your eye because the first line is on the floor of the airport as he steps into it so you see Walter from the top you see Walter just go to the left but on the ground you see the first line of that then mm. on the then as he takes his ticket as he takes his boarding pass on the background behind Air Greenland you can see the second part of that sentence then as he sits down in the plane you can see so it's a very natural way of actually I mean if you think about it it's a very natural way of delivering text because text shouldn't hold up the storyline as it flows but nobody had done it before this So it seemed like such a natural thing to do, but they've executed it very very well, which I thought is something that we should mention. But that's about it, yeah.
Right. I think this reminded me, although in every other aspect it's completely different, but it reminded me of Mr. Robot. I don't know if you guys have seen that.
I haven't seen it.
But the cinematography of Mr. Robot is taking this idea to like more of an extreme where they usually frame the characters in the bottom left corner or they are in the bottom right corner or we are looking down at the character and the majority of the frame is empty. The character is not, any character is not filling up that space. And they therefore use that space to show us other clues, whether it is like a graphic of a text popping up or something that we should be picking
up
the background. So although that is much more extreme than this, but even in Walter Mitty, they kind of made the character a little smaller and tried to show us these other...
Correct. They've used negative spaces very well.
Yeah, correct. Exactly.
And Walter is working in a negative...
Exactly. If you think about it, they are a negative asset management team.
Oh, yeah.
Mic drop.
Thank you. Chalo, bhai. I will.
Thanks for coming to our TED Talk.
Summarizes what we wanted to talk about the film.
Yeah.
Okay.
You want to make us?
तुम लोग देख लो सीक्रेट लाइफ ऑफ वॉल्टर मिटी गो एंड वॉच इट वेर एवर यू कैन एंड फिर
दिस वाज आवर टेक ऑन इट एंड इन फैक्ट वी डोंट वांट टू गिव यू बिकॉज वी वांट यू टू डिस्कवर हूएवर इज लिसनिंग वी वांट यू टू डिस्कवर हाउ इफ एनीबॉडी इज लिसनिंग लेट मी ऐड दैट आल्सो बट वी वांट यू टू डिस्कवर पार्ट्स ऑफ दिस मूवी ऑन योर ओन एंड इफ यू डू प्लीज डू टेल अस व्हाट यू लाइक्ड अबाउट इट व्हाट यू डिडंट लाइक अबाउट इट if you have any other realizations like this red pill which was a fantastic surprise for all of us
yeah also spoiler alert for everybody watching
a bit late for that yeah no but I think that's about it that's all I have to say about it do you want to conclude
Yeah. If you guys have nothing more to say, then conclude. Kar dete.
I'm done.
Okay. So, I mean, I guess that taking from the red pill, blue pill thing, there were a lot of things that we discovered from just rewatching this movie and then secondly talking about it. And we definitely got to see different aspects of it that you don't usually see when you're just watching the movie for the sake of it. So, it's definitely a very underrated movie and I hope that first of all somebody is watching this video and second of all they go and watch the movie again from the perspectives that we have spoken about here and so yeah this is a lot of fun and I think we should keep doing this about more movies regardless of whether people are watching or not
yeah that I agree with don't keep this part in but that it might cut into our viewership tum dekho na dekho hum to karne wale hain
तो बाहर में जाओ अनसब्सक्राइब मैं देखे गए ये क्या लिंक है अच्छा इनका चैनल है मैं ओपन ही नहीं करेगा
प्लीज देखो देयर इज नो हार्म इन वाचिंग दीज मूवीज बट
डेफिनेटली
But yeah, basically, so I think the reason that we started, reason that I at least wanted to do this was that I found that opinions about movies are something that kind of crystallize in a more streamlined fashion if you talk about them with people. And if you talk about them with people who also appreciate different things, then that's because Rohit, as far as I've understood, he's very technically minded and understanding this. Vyas right. is very concept driven. I would like to believe that I am a little bit more narrative minded. So this kind of, this provides me with a very wholesome analysis of a movie if I was ever to do one. So I'm very excited right. by this proposition. So I think that's why I would like to continue this in any case.
And
but
if at all anyone is watching, then you can also please comment on the channel and tell us if you want us to actually watch a movie and talk about it.
Yeah,
definitely. Apan, we can actually do an Instagram poll kind of thing. All three of us can do it if you want.
मैं इंस्टाग्राम पे नहीं बहुत बोर होता है रे इंस्टाग्राम पे प्रमोट करने को मैं नहीं करने वाला
ठीक है तो रोहित करेगा उसका फॉलोअर सबसे ज्यादा है
मैं करता हूं once this video goes live ek pe recording band kar abhi ha
kero bas abhi thank you very much bye bye theek hai thank you very much
bye bye
so that Vyas gets the point to cut bye bye bye